What's up, guys? My name is Scott, and you're watching Kentucky Ballistics. And today, we're going to do 10mm versus 44 Magnum. Now, you're probably wondering why I made this video. And honestly, today's video was just kind of spur of the moment. I had other things planned that I was going to film today, but I decided to make this video. I've noticed for a period of time now that people have been arguing which is better, 10mm or 44 Magnum. And this is when it comes to hunting, bear protection, things of that nature. You have people arguing capacity with a 10mm, people arguing power with 44 Magnum, and then you have some people that are saying 10mm is just as powerful as 44 Magnum, and calling the 10mm the new 44 Magnum. Well, I'm not here today to tell you which caliber is better, but what we are going to do is shoot some ballistics gel and compare the two. So we have two 16-inch blocks of 10% ballistics gel made by Clear Ballistics. The guns we're going to use in today's video are a Glock Gen 4 Model 20 10mm and a Ruger Super Red Hawk 44 Magnum. The ammunition used in today's video is Underwood ammo. There's a link in the description down below that will take you to their website. We're going to be using some 180 grain hollow points for the 10mm and some 200 grain hollow points. And for the 44 Magnum, we're going to be using some 240 grain hollow points and some 300 grain hollow points. I will leave the advertised ballistics for all this ammunition in the description down below. So we're doing something different in today's video. For a while now, people have been requesting that I get a chronograph. Well, enough of you have requested it that I decided to go ahead and get one. So I have purchased one. I'm just waiting for it to be delivered. Now you have to bear with me because I'm going to be new to this.
I'm new! I don't know what to do!
But I think I'll get the hang of it pretty quick. But I figure, why wait? Let's go ahead and use one in today's video. Well, it just so happens that my buddy, he purchased one recently. So today, we're going to use his chronograph. So I took three shots with the 10mm 180 grain hollow points. And we had an average of 1,250 feet per second. Then I took three shots with the 200 grain hollow point. And our average for it was 1,178 feet per second. Then we move on to the 44 Magnum. And I took three shots with a 240 grain hollow point. And we had an average of 1,513 feet per second. And then for the 300 grain hollow point, we took three shots and we had an average of 1,328 feet per second. So that pretty much covers it. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, it's just a little bit nipply. So I want to get this done as quick as possible. So we're going to start out with 10mm. We're going to shoot the 180 grain hollow point and then the 200 grain hollow point. Then we'll move on to the 44 Magnum. Okay, we had a good hit with the 180 grain hollow point, so now let's shoot the 200 grain hollow point. So you have your 180 grain hollow point on the top, and you have your 200 grain hollow point on the bottom. So the 180 grain hollow point, its wound channel is measuring almost at 17 inches. And it looks like the 200 grain hollow point wound channel is measuring at about 18 inches. Oh yeah, if you're wondering, I'm 10 yards away from the ballistics gel. I forget every time to tell you at the beginning of the video. All right, now we're gonna shoot the 44 Magnum. First up is the 240 grain hollow point. Okay, so I messed up. I'm sorry. I forgot to hit the record button when we were looking at the 44 Magnum 240 grain hollow point wound channel. But here it is afterwards, and it measured in at 24 inches. So I flipped our blocks around for this last shot, and I went ahead and removed the bullets because I don't want to hit any of these with this last shot because I do want to weigh these when we're done.
Okay, that was pretty awesome, and we blew through both blocks, but we kind of hit some gel that was already damaged, and I want to hit all fresh gel, so we're going to shoot it one more time. Perfect. So the first bullet blew through all 32 inches of gel, but you can see it kind of went through some gel that was already damaged. So I didn't want to count that, and here's that bullet. And our second shot was good. All the gel we hit was undamaged, and we went through all 32 inches of ballistics gel. And then the bullet hit right here, and then was laying here on the table.
I found these water jugs in the barn. The two on the right are kind of frozen, the one on the left isn't frozen at all. Let's blast them with the 44 Magnum.
Here's you a quick close-up of the bullets. Here's the 10mm 180 grain hollow point, the 10mm 200 grain hollow point, the 44 Magnum 240 grain hollow point, and the 44 Magnum 300 grain hollow point. Now we're going to measure these bullets. This 10mm 180 grain hollow point is going to be hard to get a measurement off of because it is really mangled. If I measure here, I'm getting 0.647. But if I measure this giant piece that's hanging off the side, I get 0.885. For the 10mm 200 grain hollow point, we're getting, oh, that's no good, 0.666. For the 44 Magnum 240 grain hollow point, we're getting 0.606. And for the 44 Magnum 300 grain hollow point, we're getting a reading of 0.669. Now we're gonna weigh the bullets. First up is the 10mm 180 grain hollow point. And we're left with 179 grains. Next is the 10mm 200 grain hollow point. And we're left with 197.9 grains. Now the 44 Magnum 240 grain hollow point. We're left with 178 grains. And now the 300 grain hollow point, 44 Magnum. We're left with 294 grains.
Okay, that's it for today. Real quick, I wanted to point out my hearing protection. These were sent to me by a pro for show. They're earmuffs that are rated up to like 34 decibels, which is pretty high for earmuffs. But they wanted me to try them out, so I'm going to wear them for a while, and then I'm going to give you guys a review over them. They sent me several of them, so I'll probably do a giveaway, or I'll just give them away to my patrons or something like that. But if you want to go ahead and check them out, I'm going to leave a link in the description down below. So for today's question, I'm going to keep it simple. Which caliber do you like best, 10mm or 44 Magnum? Leave your answers in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to the channel. If you're a new subscriber, make sure you hit that bell at the top. It's going to give you notifications when we upload new videos. If you're interested in Kentucky Ballistics clothing, there's a link in the description down below that will take you to our shop. Also in the description down below, you will find links to our Patreon, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And if you have anything you'd like to see me shoot, there's an address in the description down below that you can send your stuff to. Once again, my name is Scott. You've been watching Kentucky Ballistics, and I'll see you next time.